Hey guys, it's Zedek here. This is the Gears and Mods tutorial. So I know I'm a bit late on this. I got distracted with E3. I got really excited for that. I love that stuff. You know, it's I just got distracted. No excuses, but yeah, no. It's alright. So anyway, the video is here now, and let's go ahead and get this started. While this is getting started, got a quick question for all you guys and ladies. What did you see at E3 thus far, so far, that you're excited for? Because I saw the Metal Gear Rising footage, gameplay stuff. Oh, just oh my god. how do the white people say it? Oh my god. Oh. No, for real though. I'm a huge Metal Gear fan, so. Alright, let's see, explore, and for the sake of time management, I won't really be doing any runs. If I have time, I will do one. Let's see here. Let's go to Africa. Alright, so red light. Okay. So as you can see, I only have Tane at level 11. I'm working on Moby to get to 11 because he was one of my favorite characters for SSX 3, and so I'll be able to get him up real soon. Okay, so this is what you want. You want to have at least your suit to have boost bonus, and your board to have extra tricky time. Like I said. One and the other. You want to have both, at least both, because it does help. And this is for races. For races, if you can see, my speed isn't really up to par. My boost is fine. It's just the speed that I need to work on to get that back up. And what I like to do is I like to stock up on 3 different types of speeds. It doesn't really, for me, it doesn't really matter. As long as they're either epic or legendary speeds. Because the more speeds you have, the more you'll be able to do. I don't know. That's just the way it's been working out for me. Because my boost, as you can see, is already maxed out. And I don't really do trick it very much on this game. But that's just how I do it. And so... boost bonus with your board, as you can see, it helps, since your boost is already maxed out. An extra tricky time on your board or your suit is great for that as well. Alright, so I got my speed, and then right there, all 3 speeds, so then it should be equal up to my boost, in theory. So far in the game, it's worked out for me that way. For when I do speedruns without wingsuits on global events, and that's just how I do it. So for tricky, see if I have a tricket board. Kind of. Let's go ahead and do a tricket race real quick. Tricket. Let's go to Tane. I really don't know how to say his name. It's either Tane or Tane. I've heard it both ways. So, since I don't really have very many trigger mods, I'm just going to get these. I saw that hat. I know you guys saw it too. Rare trigger mod. You want to have the best of whatever you could find for whatever you're into. Just for trickets, you want to do the trick mods and multipliers. Like if you're on Explorer. On global events, it's different because you're kind of limited on what you can choose. But yeah, so there you go. Tricky. Don't need to worry about boost or speed. Because if you're a Tricket player, this is all you really got to worry about is your what you got to do to get your scores multiplied. So either one of these and two of the multiplayer mods, or three multiplayer mods, whatever you want to do, like the best, like legendary multiplayer mods, if they even have those. And that's what I recommend, because I have a lot of stuff. I have a lot of mods, as you can see. Okay. And, okay, for wingsuit. Wingsuit. This is what I do for wingsuit, okay? I have a few of these legendary wingsuits, but I'm saving those. But what I mostly focus on for my wingsuits are my speed. My airspeed, I want to max that out. My lift meter, my lift bar, I want to max that out as well. And my durability. Let's see if I got one of those. Oh, there it is. Alright, so as you can see, I got my speed, my airspeed maxed out. Even on my wingsuit, it's fairly maxed out, I guess. And my durability is decent, my lift is good. So, here, airspeed maxed out, durability, and, well, no, this is the airlift. Lift. Yeah, this is the lift. Lift is maxed out, durability maxed out. It doesn't really matter, epic, legendary, whatever. As long as they're all maxed out. You're gonna get the maximum use of every all three of the categories. Alright, armor. I don't really know who uses armor. I really don't use armor for really much anything, but for the mods that let you use armor mods, you can go ahead and use them. That's if you're just trying to do Explorer. For Explorer mods, that works. What I've seen a lot of people do is use their slowest board. I've seen so many people use their slowest boards just so they could ride through the track easily without going full speed, nothing. And I've seen a video where it took this guy about maybe half an hour to get the highest score, because he wasn't even like boosting, he was just taking his sweet time. And yeah, he used the armor and armor mods. That's pretty much what you have to do for that. And again, for if you need armor and spikes, same thing, you know, use the what you want to do is you want to max out durability and max out sharpness. And then after that, you could use it for whatever, anything else. But since this one only has two, you only need to use two slots. And same thing for this one. If you're trying to survive the longest, I recommend using two slots for each of these. And then this one for whatever you want to do. Speed or boost mod. Doesn't matter, because you're trying to finish as fast as you can. On survival, especially. And alright, range on this one, same thing. If you're trying to do survival in one of those mist maps where you can't see anything, same thing. Range, intensity, and battery life. Even with the headlight, the headlamp, you want to do the same thing. I think the headlamp only has two, but if it has three, you want to do the same thing. That's just how it works. That's just how you get the max use of it. Okay. So, I know this video is a bit long, but it's alright. Let's see what else I have to show you guys. Headlamp gear. Oxygen tanks. That's right. Kari has an oxygen tank. Alright, for oxygen tank, you want to use two mods for that. Let's go to race it real quick. So for survival mode, for survival mode, if you're maxed out on your character, 2 mods, see, O2, if you're level 11, tank size, max that out, oxygen quality, max that out, and with 3 mods, you could add booster, speed mod, whatever you need to do. Okay. So see, I had one of these. I'll add this one, and since my lift is all right, I'll add a durability mod. All right, let's see how I do on this track. This isn't gonna be like I'm not really gonna go for a time at the moment, but. At least you're gonna see how I do things and just the way it works. I love my new playlist though, that's for sure. I love this playlist. Holy crap. I almost messed that up. Okay. Jesus, oh boy. I'm not really used to doing live commentary when I'm doing recordings, but you know, I'm trying. Jesus Christ. I already fucked up. Excuse my language. What's the fastest time on this thing? Like, a minute 35 or something like that? I don't even remember. Yeah, I see. But anyway, if I really tried on this one, I could actually beat, yeah, I could definitely beat that time. As you can see, that's not too bad. Anyway, let's go back to globe. Anyway, hopefully this tutorial helped you guys. There's gonna be some more coming out next week. I'm gonna post on mercurycity.com 4 more maps and suggestions for you guys to vote on, and hopefully we'll see what that leads up to in a couple days. And thank you guys for watching. You subs are awesome, and everybody that loves my videos and is a fan, thank you. And hopefully I'll see you guys on the slopes. You guys have an awesome day. Enjoy E3, because I know I am. And yeah, have a good time, guys.